Hi aspirants, welcome you to my YouTube channel Learn with Smutiranjan. In this video we are going to learn about current affairs of date 5th March 2019. In this video we know about the latest current affair of this date. So let's start the current affairs. First news: 1000 MW NTPL project dedicated to nation. Coal Minister Piyush Goyal dedicated to the nation a 1000 MW thermal power project of Neyveli Tamil Nadu Power Limited on 4th March 2019. He also dedicated 150 MW solar power project of NLC India Limited NLCIL in Tamil Nadu. The 1000 MW coal-fired thermal power project of NTPL is a joint venture between NLCIL and TANGEDCO with equity participation of 89:11. And the next is Project Bold QIT inaugurated. Project Bold QIT border electronically dominated QIT interception technique on India-Bangladesh border in Assam was inaugurated on 5th March 2019. INT wing of BSF undertook the project in January 2018 and completed it in record time. In completion of this project will help BSF to curb all types of cross-border crimes and provide respite to the troops from round-the-clock human surveillance. And the next news is Uttarakhand to set up COE for Himalayan fiber. The Uttarakhand government has decided to set up a center of excellence for Himalayan fiber in Almora district of Kumaon. It will be set up with support from the Northern India Textile Research Association NITRA Ghaziabad. NITRA under the Union Minister of Textile will set up a training institute for developing fiber products at the center. And next news, handloom hat at Janpath inaugurated. Textile Minister Smriti Irani inaugurated the refurbished handloom hat at Janpath in New Delhi on March 5, 2019. The main objective of the hat is to provide infrastructure support to handloom agencies to augment their sales of handloom products. She also launched three projects besides this, which are trend forecasting, design innovation incubator and textile and craft repository. The next news is Azadi ke Diwano Museum inaugurated. Minister of State for Culture and Environment Dr. Mahesh Sharma inaugurated Azadi Diwane Museum at Red Fort Delhi on 5th March 2019. It is created by the Archaeological Survey of India and pays homage to all unsung heroes of freedom struggle of the nation. The museum is fifth in the series of recently inaugurated museum in the Red Fort complex, inaugurated Subha Chandra Bose Museum. Appointments: Burton Indian Sports Administrator Randhir Singh was appointed as the chairman of the coordination committee of the 2022 Hangzhou Asian Games by the General Assembly of the Olympic Council of Asia. Beverage major Coca-Cola India appointed Nishi Chaturvedi as Vice President Human Resources India and Southwest Asia. Then important merger and purchase. Zomato will sell its UAE food delivery business to Germany's Delivery Hero Group for about $172 million. ICICI Bank will acquire 9.9% stake in non-banking finance company Kisan Finance for cash consideration of rupees 17.82 crores. Bell to set up EV charger network. Bell will be setting up a network of solar-based electronic vehicle charger on the Delhi-Chandigarh highway. The project will be covered under the Department of Heavy Industry FAME scheme. Faster adoption and manufacturing of hybrid and electronic vehicles in India. EV chargers would allow range and safety among the electric vehicle user and bolster their confidence for intercity travel. Next, 96% uses of toilet under Swachh Bharat. The National Annual Rural Sanitation Survey NARSS 2018-19 found that 96.5% of the households in rural India who have access to a toilet use it. The survey also reconfirmed the open defecation free ODF status of 90.7% of villages. The survey was conducted between November 2018 and February 2019, covering 92040 households in 6136 villages across the country. Air pollution costing India $30 billion a year. Air pollution due to crop stubble burning in northern India causes an economic loss of $30 billion annually, as per a study unveiled on 4th March 2019. Researchers from the US-based International Food Policy Research Institute found that living in districts with air pollution from crop stubble burning can cause acute respiratory infection, ARI. This is first of its kind study. Next. New airport inaugurated. PM Narendra Modi will launch civilian flight operation from Hindon Air Base on 8 March 2019. He will also inaugurate the 9.4 km long Dil's Garden new bus adda section of Delhi Metro rail line. Sindhudurg Airport in Parauli CP area of Maharashtra, Konkan region was inaugurated by Chief Minister Devendra Fadanvis and Union Civil Aviation Minister Suresh Prabhu on 5th March 2019. Guinness Book of World Record for Kumbh Mela. The Prayagraj Kumbh Mela 2019 secured a place in the Guinness Book of World Record. It set the record for a largest crowd management, largest sanitation drive and largest painting exercise of public site. The festival began on January 14 and concluded on March 4, 2019. With the sixth and final Shahi Snan on the occasion of Mahashivaratri. Next news. India tops in consumer confidence survey. India topped the global consumer confidence survey conducted in collaboration with Nielsen. The survey was conducted over the internet and polled more than 32,000 consumers in 64 countries across Asia, Pacific, Europe, Latin America, the Middle East, Africa, and North America. India had a consumer confidence index score of 133 in the fourth quarter of 2018. RBI slapped fine on four banks. RBI imposed a total monetary fine of rupees 8 crore on three banks: Karnataka Bank, United Bank of India, and Karur Vysya Bank. Banks were charged for non-compliance of direction on SWIFT machine software. Rupees 4 crore fine was imposed on Karnataka Bank. United Bank faced a penalty of 3 crore and 1 crore fine on Karur Vysya Bank. Rupees 1 crore was also charged on Yes Bank for the same reason. Next, how to earn while you learn, click to know. Textbook is a one-stop solution which helps online exam aspirants to know more about various opportunities in the government sector and prepare with the test service and live classes. Native your friends to textbook.com. When your friend purchases a textbook, pass or course, you earn rupees 50 for every friend. Your friend who get rupees 25 Paytm cashback on purchase. And next, Shikha Jhalona in top 5 women ODI ranking. Two Indian bowler, Jhulna Goswami and Shikha Pandey, joined the top 5 club in the latest ICC Women World Cricket ranking for ODI bowler issued on March 4, 2019. Shikha Pandey was placed joint third along with South Africa's Dance Can Nykerk. Veteran passer Jhalona Goswami topped the latest ICC Women's Cricket ranking. And next, India-Bangladesh began joint exercise. The 8th edition of the joint military exercise Samprati between India and Bangladesh began on 3rd March 2019 in Tangil, Bangladesh. Samprati aims to increase mutual cooperation between the armies of two countries. Bangladesh side was represented by 36th East Bengal Battalion, while India side was represented by 19th Battalion of the Rajputana Rifle. And next, PM Sharma Yogi Mandhan Yojana launched. Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched the Pradhan Mantri Sharma Yogi Mandhan Yojana at Gandhinagar. This is a national pension scheme for worker and laborers of unorganized sector. It will provide a monthly pension of 3,000 rupees to the employees of the unorganized sector after 60 years of age. The scheme will benefit 10 crore workers in unorganized sector. ISRO launched Young Scientist Program. ISRO launched a special program for school children called Young Scientist Program. Yuva Vigyani Karyakram. It is preliminarily aimed at imparting basic knowledge on space technology, space science and space application to the younger ones. It will be of around a 2-week duration during summer holidays and students of the 9th standard are eligible for it. Next, Sanjeev Rajan to be the new road transport secretary. Senior IS officer Sanjeev Rajan was named Secretary, Minister of Road Transport and Highways. He is the chairman of National Highways Authority of India at present and has been appointed an office on special duty in Morat. Nagendranath Sinha will replace him as the new NHAI chief. Next, Gurgaon is the most polluted city. Gurgaon topped the list of the most polluted city in the world in a recent study conducted by NGO Greenpeace India. It was ranked first among 62 polluted cities in the report Global Air Pollution 2018. The report measures the air quality in terms of PM2.5 data as aggregated through the IQ Air Air Visuals platform in 2018. Next, obituaries. Ex-Union Minister B. Dhananjay Kumar passed away. He was Cabinet Minister for Civil Aviation and Tourism in 1996. Actor Luke Perry died. He rose to fame in the hit 1990s television series Beverly Hills 90210. And next, Vice President on visit to Paraguay. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu is on a two nation visit to Paraguay and Costa Rica. The 8-day tour aims at strengthening bilateral ties with the two Latin American countries. President of Paraguay, Mario Abdo Benitez. President of Costa Rica, Carlos Alvarado Quesada. So, aspirant, this is the current affair of 5th March 2019. Stay tuned with us to learn about next date current affairs. Please like, share, and subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.